Hello, I'm Dr. Arundhati, an educationist and a linguist. I have been getting a lot of requests to make videos on spoken Kannada. People from the southern belt follow Kannada at least to some extent and quickly learn to speak also. But there are a lot of people from Bihar, UP, Bengal, Gujarat, and Punjab working in Bangalore, especially in the IT sector. For them, Kannada is completely a different language. So I'm making a series of, learn to speak Kannada through English, these videos. And I may come up with the same series through Hindi also. So let us begin. Today I will be talking about the pronunciation basically in this video. And then the following videos will have a lot of sentences and everything. So happy learning. So, like any other Indian language, we have swaras and vyanjanas. That is, we have vowels and consonants. If you look at the first line, a, a, e, u, u, r, ru, e, ai, o, au, am, aha. That is the line what you will get. So, if you carefully now please listen to the pronunciation. I'm not wanting you to learn, or I can't make you very proficient in reading and writing Kannada. That much time I don't have. I would love to do it though. So, what happens is I'll be basically taking you through all the sounds. So, please understand the sounds. So, a, a, e, u, u, ru. Ru, this is Rushiwala Ru. Okay, Rutu, Rushi, like that. So, A, I. Generally in Hindi we have AI, but this A, Dirghwala, that is special of Kannada. A, I. O, au. In Hindi we have O, au. So, here it is O, au. Then, aha. These are the swaras. Then we come to vyanjanas or consonants. I mean, just like Hindi, you have like, ka, cha, ta, pa group is there. So the first one is like a ka, kha, ga, kha, nga, cha, cha. I'll be writing capital C here to understand the sound better. Ja, jha. Yeah. T, I'll be using capital T to write T. T. D, capital D to write, have this sound. D. D. N. T. D. D. N. This is Dhanushwala Dh. This is dh. This is dh. Then the last labial group is p, h, phal, b, bh, bhasma, bhangar, like that. Bh, m. Then we have unstructured consonants that do not fall into any of the above structures. That is y, r. This is r. This is not in use anymore now. And then l, w, sh. I'm writing sh as sh. Sh, s, h, l. To represent this l sound, I'll be writing capital L. Again, this is r. This also is not there. Pallam. I think that they still use it in Tamil. Then ksha and jna. Now jna, actually, this is again from Sanskrit. It's similar to Sanskrit. In North, they call it as gya, and that is yagya. But in I mean in South, it is called as jna. So yagya or yajna, these are same. All right. I hope This is just a beginning to set tone and to understand the pronunciation. Once we are thorough with the pronunciation, I'll be posting a lot of videos on your, you know, vocabulary building and also on vocabulary building as well as sentence formation. Thank you so much. If you like it, like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.